गुड मॉर्निंग व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल बायो श्रीनिवास चैनल। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी बी इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू टू एक्सप्लेन द इवेंट्स एंड द स्टेप्स इन द रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस, स्पेशली इन द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। दिस टॉपिक बिलोंग टू द सेकंड चैप्टर इन द 10th क्लास बायोलॉजी। लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द इवेंट्स एंड आर स्टेप्स in the process of respiration. The first step we can popularly call as breathing. Breathing means intaking of air and outgoing of air, generally called as breathing. Then during breathing, what happening actually in the body? The oxygen is taken inside along with the air and settled in the lungs. At the same time, the carbon dioxide, which is from different body parts, is sent out from the lungs to outside. That is exhalation. So the combination of inhalation and exhalation is generally termed as breathing process. Then after breathing, what's going on in the lungs? In the second step or second event of the respiration process, the gaseous exchange between blood and alveoli. This is the second event after the breathing. What happening here? The blood, you know very well, it brings the used air along with carbon dioxide into the lungs. And that blood vessels which are bringing the carbon dioxide from each and every part of our body into the lungs are inbuilt with some millions of air bubble-like structures called alveoli. For example, if you see the alveolus, the singular form of alveoli is alveolus. This is the air bubble like structure where the air entered in alveolus. It contains oxygen as well as carbon dioxide also. Then around the alveolus there is a thin blood vessel, generally called as capillary. This is called as capillary. Hurry forward. It is bringing the blood with carbon dioxide from each and every part of our body. And it is containing carbon dioxide, so I am showing with blue color. It contains carbon dioxide. Then what about oxygen? Oxygen is also present, but less when compared to atmospheric air. Then what are the percentages of the oxygen carbon dioxide in the air? And what are the percentages of carbon dioxide and oxygen in the blood, which is from different parts of our body? Let us see. This is estimated as 16%, which one? Oxygen. And carbon dioxide is estimated as 4% in the blood, which is from different body parts. And in the air, usually you know very well, in the air, the oxygen percentage is estimated as 21% approximately, and carbon dioxide percentage is 0.03. I'll follow. Then there is an exchange of gases here at the alveolar level in the lungs. How and which gases are exchanged? According to the process of diffusion, the movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration, till the concentrations on both the sides becomes equal without the supply of energy is called diffusion. So here, according to the definition of diffusion, the oxygen from the air diffused into the blood and carbon dioxide, which is 4%, now diffused into the air. So oxygen is added to the blood and carbon dioxide leaves the blood in the alveolar level. Up to here, the blue colored blood is generally nothing but deoxygenated blood. Up to here. When the oxygen is added, then it is now represented with the red color dots. And now this blood is having more amount of oxygen and less amount of carbon dioxide. This is called oxygenated blood. Now the oxygenated blood is carried with the blood vessels from the lungs to different parts of the body. That we will discuss in the third step. Then what is the third step in the events of respiration process if you observe? The third step in the respiration process is nothing but transport of oxygenated blood to the tissues, then which blood vessels will transport the oxygenated blood? You know very well, in our body there are two types of blood vessels. One is arteries, the second one is veins. Arteries are always carrying oxygenated blood, whereas veins will carry deoxygenated blood from different parts of the body to the heart. But arteries are carrying oxygenated blood from the heart to different parts of the body. In this way, the transportation of oxygenated blood takes place after the completion of oxygenation in the lungs. In the lungs, the process which is carried is called as oxygenation. Means addition of oxygen and removal of carbon dioxide. Are you following? In this way, the gases transportation takes place by the blood into tissues. From the tissues, what is tissue actually? The group of cells which performing similar function, having common origin and looks similar in shape and structure is called a tissue. So that step is nothing but the transportation of blood, which is blood, oxygenated blood to tissues takes place. Then after this, the fourth step what is the fourth step? Cellular respiration. Cellular respiration. Here you see the cellular respiration process is the respiration in which there is a breaking of glucose molecules in presence of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, water, with liberation of more amount of energy at cellular level. So it is called cellular respiration. Then how the gases are exchanged in the cells? The same principle what I explained in the case of alveoli, in the same way the exchange of gases takes place at cellular level also. For example, this is the cell in our body. This centrally one is called nucleus, and this is the cell membrane, and the middle one is the jelly like substance, what you will call as cytoplasm, and having so many cellular organelles, isn't it? In the cytoplasm, the percentage of oxygen is less because it is utilized for different cellular activities. So the amount of oxygen in the cytoplasm of the cell is estimated as 16%, and the amount of carbon dioxide in the cytoplasm is estimated as 4%, because it performed so many cellular activities. As a result, the amount of carbon dioxide increased in the cytoplasm of the cell. So it is estimated as 4%. Now there is a blood vessel, or we can say the blood capillary, which is connected. Imagine this is the blood capillary. Which blood capillary? Arteriole. Arteriole is nothing but the capillary of the artery. Now it is bringing which type of blood? The oxygenated blood. That's why red color. This blood contains the oxygen percentage is 21%, and carbon dioxide 0.03. Then according to the process of diffusion, what is the process of diffusion here? In the cytoplasm of the cell, the amount of oxygen is less when compared to the blood, which is from arteriole. What the percentage here? 21%, here 16. So automatically what happened? The oxygen from the blood diffused in. Are you followed? And here the carbon dioxide percentage is 4, but in the air, means in the oxygenated blood or in the blood in the arteriole, is 0.03. So the carbon dioxide sent out into the arteriole containing blood. Are you followed? In this way, the oxygen is absorbed by the cell and carbon dioxide is given out by the cell. When this happens, this oxygen now works on the glucose. Means it breaks the glucose molecule to produce carbon dioxide water with liberation of energy. In this way, the exchange of gases takes place at the cellular level. After that, the cellular respiration is carried time to time without any lapse of time. Around about 1/1000 of a second also, there is no gap. So like this, the respiration process is a cyclic process. Always the carbon dioxide is given out and oxygen is received. In this way, there are 4 to 5 events we can observe in the process of respiration. I hope you understood clearly. Thank you one and all, and have a nice day.